And a voice will call out saying, ذَلِكَ يَوْمُ الْخُرُوجِ. This is the day of resurrection. Israfil alayhi salam will blow into the trumpet. And as people are rising, they look at others and they see them rising from their graves one by one. As the trumpet is heard, the earth will split open from every grave and you will see them rising before your eyes. ذَلِكَ حَشْرٌ عَلَيْنَا يَسِيرٌ. Allah says, this is simple for us. We can do this very simply.
Indeed, the hour of reckoning has come very close to man, and yet man is turning away in oblivion, forgetfulness. And the trumpet shall be blown, and absolutely everything shall be destroyed into pieces, besides that which Allah wills, subhanallah. Everything will be destroyed when the trumpet will be blown. It is known as the day of the loud scream. In Surah Abbas, Allah says, the day that you will hear a loud yell, a loud noise, a loud scream. Everybody will be screaming, everybody will be yelling. There will be chaos, people will be running from side to side. Allah says, on that day there will be a huge catastrophe, huge calamity. Allahu Akbar. Allah's anger will overtake absolutely everything. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala describes the day that you shall see the end. Every female who is pregnant shall miscarry automatically because of the sound. People will seem intoxicated, completely drunk, yet they will not be intoxicated in any way. But the punishment of Allah will be immense, intense and severe. And Allah says, on that day, nobody will be able to help another person. He says, on that day, what will happen? The eyes will be dazed because of the flashes of light, of the destruction of everything around. And the moon will be eclipsed completely. Neither the moon nor the sun, nothing shall be seen. The sun and the moon will come together. Man will say, where can I run to on this day? He will dart that way and dart this way and dart the other way. There will be chaos. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us the day that the stars will be dimmed completely. They will be gone, extinguished. Their function is over. The sky will crack. The sky will burst. It will start to crack. Allahu Akbar. And Allah says, the mountains that you see will actually become powder. They will be powderized with so much heat that they will be like clouds. When you see the mountains now, they seem to you very solid. Allah says they will be moving like clouds, just dust particles in the atmosphere. Those will be the mountains you knew. On that day, we will roll the sky up like the rolling of a scroll. Allahu Akbar. Then Allah says, every single person is going to be brought forth, starting from the time of Adam alayhi salam, right up to the last person.
All the ones who were in the beginning of the creation and all the ones who are at the end of the creation, لَمَجْمُعُونَ, they are going to be gathered to an appointed place which is known. And this is when resurrection will happen, in the second blowing of the trumpet. Allah will recreate Israfil alayhi salam, and then he will say to him, blow again to the trumpet. He will blow a second time, وَنُفِخَ فِيهِ أُخْرَى فَإِذَا هُمْ قِيَامٌ يَنْظُرُونَ. Second time it will be blown, and therefore after that they will be raised, watching, staring.
The earth shall be stretched, a long stretch, and everybody will fit on what is known as the arasat of qiyamah. Only Allah knows where exactly that will be.
Allah says in the Quran, on that day the earth and the sky, they'll all be changed, because the conditions of the living state and the state of the body and soul on that day is actually different. On that day, you will be able to see things which in this life you are unable to see. When I say unable, meaning your body in its physical form, in its current form, cannot withstand its sight. You'll die. And now if we look into the sun long enough, we become blind. That's how weak we are. The universe, the way it is created now, is in such a way that Allah has created laws around it. These laws, which Allah has created in this universe, prevent us from seeing beyond what we see. We can only discover what's in here. In the hereafter, Allah will recreate the earth in a different way and the universe in a different way, so that it will cater for the situation on that day. The angels will descend. You will see the shayateen and the jinns. You will see things that cannot have been seen in this life, and you will be equipped to see it on that day. On that day, no one can die. And the state of the body and soul will be different to the state of the body and soul here. We are now temporarily connected. Our soul is temporarily connected to our body. That's why when you go to sleep, you go unconscious. And when you die, it's temporarily disconnected. On the day of judgment, it is permanently connected, the soul and the body. So you are in a state different to this one. But your feelings, emotions, pain, your conscience, all of the awareness is multiplied.
And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, there will be billions and trillions and quadrillions of people, all of them from the beginning right to the end. And do you know what? Allah describes it. Allah says, then the trumpet shall be blown a second time and everybody will be resurrected after the end.
And your sight is sharp, meaning you see things clear as clear can be. Much more clearer than here. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, you were before this, meaning in the former life, you were blinded to many things. We took the veil away from you today, and your eyesight is sharp. Allah says in the Quran, when the trumpet is blown, and the earth is destroyed and so on, and the day of judgment comes,
every person will come with an angel who will be pulling or driving that person together with a witness. The angel who was with you all your life will come as a witness against you or for you. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us.
This will be a day of torment and hardship. It will not be easy.
The light of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will lighten the earth. Subhanallah. That will be the light on that day. Your Rabb, your Creator, your Sustainer, the one who took your life away, the one who resurrected you thereafter. Allah, He says, He will come and the angels will come in rows.
وَتَتَلَقَّاهُمُ الْمَلَائِكَةُ And the angels will run to the believers, catching them and holding them. تَتَلَقَّى It's like embracing, hugging, to give you comfort and safety. Like a mother holds a child from a fire or away from terror. هَذَا يَوْمُكُمُ الَّذِي كُنْتُمْ تُوَعَدُونَ This is the day that you have been promised. Don't worry. Don't worry. The angels will say that to the believers. And they will say, this fire and this terror is not for you. أَلَّا خَوْفٌ عَلَيْهِمْ وَلَا هُمْ يَحْزَنُونَ There is no harm upon them of fear, nor will they be saddened. The true loyal people of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the close ones, there will be no fear or sadness upon them on that day.
On that day, we will bring Jahannam forth. We will let Jahannam come right onto the point where we are taking account. So when Jahannam sees the criminals, listen to what happens. Allah says, Subhanallah. As the criminals see Jahannam, Jahannam will make a roaring, bubbling, crackling sound, inviting sound to tell them, this is your abode. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us protection. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will ask, is this not the day? Did I not promise you of this day? Allahu Akbar.
The people will call out, please our Lord, lessen the pain. Please our Lord, return us back. Please our Lord, give us another chance. Please our Lord, have mercy upon us. People will cry until the tears run out and then they begin to cry blood.
On that day, every single person will come pleading their case, debating, fighting, arguing, trying to save themselves, to say, no, it wasn't like this, it was like that. It was like this, it was like that. And Allah will say, no, hang on, just pause for a moment. In Surah Yasin, Allah says, on that day we will seal their mouths. We don't want you to talk, you are lying. Allah says, their hands will have mouths to talk to us. The hands will bear witness to what you touched, what you stole, what you took, what you earned, what you spent, everything. The hand will talk. And Allah says, the legs will be speaking, the skin will talk. The skin will bear witness, Allahu Akbar. The body organs will bear witness on that day. So Allah says, look, we don't need witnesses from anywhere else besides your own organs, Allahu Akbar.
People will be gathered on the day of judgment on three types, three ways. There will be a group, a type that will be able to walk on your legs, meaning. And there will be a type that will come riding on something. They won't need to stand, they'll be riding. And there will be a group that will be gathered on their faces. And it was asked, O Messenger of Allah, how can people walk on their face? The Prophet ﷺ replied, the one who could make people walk on their legs will be able to make people walk on their faces on the Day of Judgment, very easily. Those people who walk on their faces are the criminals. The ones who did things against Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's laws. As for the ones who are riding, they are the believers with great deeds. Those who are muttaqeen will be gathered on the day of judgment on vehicles riding. And they'll be driven to heaven in the end on vehicles riding. What is al-muttaqeen? Al-Muttaqoon are people who used to protect themselves from the wrath of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this world. You knew this was haram, you knew it would anger Allah, you knew that there is a sin for it, so you protected yourself from it. This is called muttaqi. The angels will give them good news, and they will say to them, this is your day that you've been promised. Don't worry. As for the criminals, Allah says, and we will gather the criminals and drive them along. They'll be driven like prisoners with chains, locked up, driven in different states. Wirda meaning thirsty, extreme thirst. At this point, my dear brothers and sisters, these gatherings that I'm talking about, judgment has not begun yet. Every person is in that state. And Allah describes that we are looking up in terrified eyes. We don't know what's going to happen. Yes, you may have many good deeds, but who have you harmed? Who will take your deeds today? Is there something you've forgotten? No one is sure what is going to happen to them.